Hi everyone, Ellery the Health Adventurer here, and today I wanted to talk to you guys about fruitarian teeth problems. So I have been a raw vegan fruitarian for the last 6 months, and overall it's been going really, really well for me. I was suffering with some symptoms that were looking like lupus, scleroderma, rheumatoid arthritis, and possibly even multiple sclerosis. I didn't get any of these things officially diagnosed, although I do have some blood work that indicates that I was on a path for those kinds of things. Nonetheless, I had a lot of success switching over to a raw vegan fruitarian diet. I was unable to move my hands. Sometimes they would not open for me. So I was having a lot of issues. It seemed neurological to me what was going on. And once I switched over to actually just 100% fruit, that's when I started really seeing these problems just completely go away. So on the other hand, though, I did have a few issues show up with my teeth. But I now, 6 months later, I am not really having too many issues with my teeth. The only thing I notice right now in the last couple of days, I did notice that it looks like there's kind of like a stain color on my teeth. So I'm going to try and address that possibly with some activated charcoal or some lemon or something like that to try to whiten them up a little bit. But before, I was actually having issues with tooth sensitivity, so, and now I'm not really having those issues anymore. Maybe I'll notice every once in a while just a tiny little twinge, but before it was actually kind of, it was like a shock, and it was just like kind of like an excruciating pain for a second, and then it would go away, but just from drinking something like water. So I wanted to talk a little bit about what I've learned about this and why I believe that it's no longer an issue for me. So, first of all, I want to talk about some of the things that other people tend to address around fruitarian teeth issues. Number one is vitamins and minerals. So a lot of people suggest that it can be related to a vitamin or mineral deficiency. So calcium, vitamin D, vitamin K2, maybe even magnesium, all these things are, they work together. So, you know, and calcium is something that, you know, if you're having issues with your teeth, obviously, calcium is the biggest one. So if you can always try adding like a supplement to see if that helps you. Obviously consult with your doctor. But that is something that you might want to look into, is to adding a supplement. So for me, I didn't personally find that supplementing really was doing anything. I was still having a lot of issues and I was having a hard time figuring out what was going on. Unfortunately, if I eat vegetables, I have a lot of issues that triggers my hands not working. So trying to scale back on fruit wasn't really an option because I was sure that fruit was actually what was causing the problem. So in a way, it kind of was, but also not in the way that that we think. So first of all, a lot of people think that fruit is very acidic. So, and it is, when if you take a pH strip and you measure the fruit by itself, you'll see that it is actually quite acidic. But if you eat it and you test your pH before and after you eat, so that's the key to see the difference. Beforehand, you know, you'll probably find that you're within a range of, you know, between 6.5 and 7 pH. Most adults are at around a 6.5 pH. But if you eat some fruit and then right after, if you test your pH, you'll notice that it's actually alkaline. And the key is definitely, you know, make sure you're eating ripe fruit, you know, acidic, especially citrus, if it's picked unripe, maybe a little bit acidic. So just be careful with that. I personally find that I can't eat things like pineapple because it's just picked way too unripe and that actually triggers me. So definitely watch out for that. But for example, I was really surprised to find that when I had cantaloupe, a nice ripe cantaloupe, that the pH in my mouth was a 9. So that is really alkaline, and that's definitely not going to be pulling calcium or anything from the teeth that way. So, you know, could it be causing some other issue if it was like too alkaline? That I don't really know. That was a thought that crossed my mind, but I don't believe so. I think actually what's going on, and this is according to Dr. Robert Morse's theory, is that when you eat a lot of fruit, it's pulling a lot of acid out of you. So if you're having a lot of acidity problems in your mouth, it's actually because of the detox that's coming out of you. And something I noticed for myself was sometimes at night, you know, after I've eaten already and brushed my teeth and everything, and I'm just laying down, and maybe I'll notice like it's like my salivary glands are kind of active for some reason, and it seems like it's got kind of maybe almost a sour taste or something to it is the way that I would maybe describe it. But it seems kind of acidic, whatever is coming out. So probably in those cases, it's a good idea to maybe rinse the mouth out or something like that. But that is another thing that you can do too if you're having a lot of issues with doing a fruitarian type of a diet and you're noticing these things show up, is make sure every time you eat, you know, or just whenever you notice that your mouth is kind of acidic or something like that, rinse out your mouth with water, with baking soda. I even have a heal-all tea from Dr. Robert Morse that I've just started. I tried it a couple days ago. And what I do is I actually, to keep it more raw, I don't know if this is actually really raw, but I just soak it instead of like heating the tea. I just soak it overnight and I just use the tea that way. And then I just rinse my mouth out and spit it out. You know, I actually kind of use it almost like a, like I would do for like an oil pulling. That's also another recommendation that has been offered to me from some other raw vegans in the community, is to try oil pulling. And also, you know, make sure that you're using either a natural toothpaste, if you're, you know, maybe something more like Tom's of Maine, or I personally actually use baking soda. I don't really mind the taste. I actually, because I'm not getting any salt any other place in my diet, I kind of feel like it gives me a little bit of sodium. So that's what I personally use. And you can always, I'm sure there's plenty of natural toothpaste recipes out there that you can look for. Because one of the things that has been suggested, I believe it was Don Bennett who said this, that the glycerin in the toothpaste actually coats your teeth. So your teeth have a natural process, and your saliva glands have this natural process of remineralizing. So if you have glycerin on your teeth, it's coating it after you're done brushing it. That can make it more difficult for your saliva to remineralize your teeth. So another thing that you can try from Dr. Robert Morse is parathyroid glandular. The parathyroid gland is actually responsible for calcium utilization. So sometimes it may not be that you're not getting enough calcium. It could also be that you are malabsorbed and maybe have some blockages in the colon area. So you can do something like the Fab Four kit with Dr. Morse to make sure you're hitting the adrenals, you're hitting the kidneys, you're getting the GI tract, and you're getting the lymph moving. So doing those four together. But if you're just looking for a specific, you know, glandular, one other thing you might want to do is take a look at your eyes, do an iridology, look up iridology, find out what that is, and kind of learn how your eyes are mapped out and how they show the health or lack of health, I guess, of your body. And that might help you determine if you may have some sort of parathyroid weakness going on. For me personally, I know I've dealt a lot with like depression. So those are things that can definitely go hand in hand with parathyroid weakness. So for me, if I wanted to, I haven't tried any kind of glandular for that. But that is something else that I could do if I wanted to really help support that gland. But for me, the key has really just been to stay with the fruit, because I believe that, you know, if I continue to just eat the fruitarian diet, that my body is really going to start healing itself as it already has. So those are really, really important things. So definitely, you know, again, like I was saying, depression could be something that can affect your calcium utilization. So, you know, just really take good care of yourself. Keep your stress low as much as you can. Learn to manage stress. Learn to meditate. All those kinds of things. So just taking in the whole picture in that. So if you are actually finding that fruit is too detoxifying for you, what you can do is back off of your detox. That is something that can help as well. So I personally, obviously, I cannot do vegetables as I've already explained, but I did incorporate for a little bit of time. I did a lot of coconut and a lot of avocado, just as much as I could really handle until I got kind of to a breaking point where I was like, I really need my fruit again. So, and that actually seemed to work out pretty well for me. Different ways that people can back off of detox include more green juices, so that might really benefit you for a variety of different reasons. Also, just incorporating more vegetables, more salads, and things like that, if you can, if that's something that you can incorporate into your diet and you don't have the kind of neurological symptoms and things, reactions to vegetables that I was having. Something else, even if you have to, if you have to do cooked food or something like that, really depending on how intense your detox is, I wouldn't necessarily recommend doing cooked food, personally, but if you have to, whatever you have to do in order to keep on a healthy path. And a lot of people aren't necessarily 100% raw and they do quite well. So it's really about you have to listen to your body and figure out what works for you. Of course, talk to your doctor if you need to. Hopefully a naturopath or someone like that who is aware of the raw vegan diet, would be really beneficial. So, as always, I just want to let you know I am not a doctor. This is not medical advice. I'm just sharing with you my experience and what I have learned about the raw vegan diet and some of these other alternative methods. So, those are my tips and tricks for the fruitarian tooth problems. Hopefully, that's a little bit helpful for you. I'm always learning more and more and more about all of these things. And it's really always hard to say necessarily what is going on, what is the cause of something. It can be really difficult to figure that out. So, the key is really just listening to your body, adjusting as needed, and making gradual transitions. If you can find somebody to help you out with figuring out, blood work and things like that, that can be really useful. Dr. Rick Dina is somebody who I have been interested in keeping my eye out for working with to do some lab work to find out if there were any potential deficiencies or anything like that. Just in general, not just for my teeth, but just for my overall health. So, finding somebody who is more open to the raw vegan diet is really helpful. He is a raw vegan himself, so that might be helpful information for you if you're looking for somebody to work with. So, anyways, I hope you enjoy this video. Please subscribe if you want to learn more about my journey doing the raw vegan diet, and also if you want to learn some of my little tips and tricks if it's something that you're interested in trying as well. And you can visit my website, thehealthadventurer.com, if you want to learn more there. So please give me a like if you like this video, and I will see you in the next one. Bye-bye.